Hi there. I'm Doug Moss, one of the pastors of Pathfinder Church, and we're in the last week of Advent, which means Christmas is only a few days away. And so as we anticipate this great and glorious moment that's coming up, we want to take some time to continue to reflect, to see what God is doing even in the meantime, even as we are waiting for Christmas Day. And we're going to look at what God does in those seasons. So in a little bit, we're going to be joined by Chris and Corbin, and they're going to talk about something that's pretty important, that over the last couple of years, we've all had to learn how to do connection and community differently. We've had to adjust to different regulations and hazards, and we've had to carve out new ways to find a life-giving connection with others. And Chris is gonna share a little bit of his story about what that's looked like for him in his life. But before we get to that, we've got a special treat for you. We have a virtual choir that's gonna lead us in a song of praise to our God.
And this here is my Uncle Chris. I mean, he's not technically my uncle, but I'll let him explain.
Yeah, you know, I moved here from East Tennessee, and that was about 8 years ago, which is really hard to believe. And I left a place that I had really grown up my whole life. I left a great community of friends. I left family. I left a job that I loved. I left a great church. And I left all of that because I felt God leading me on a new journey that ultimately brought me here. And that has been a great move. And one of the reasons I say it has been such a great move is that I have seen how God, over the last 8 years, has really given me a brand new community here. And Corbin is part of that community. You know, I think about the fact that I have one biological nephew, and I have one biological niece. But since I've moved here to St. Louis, God has given me like 10 other nieces and nephews that aren't really mine, but they kind of are. And so I'm just really grateful that that God's given me that.
How would you describe what community means to you?
Yeah, you know, community has been something that I feel like I understood. And something that was something that I guess I've been aware of my whole life. And when I think about it, I think, oh, community is having friends around you, which that is a part of it. And that's something that I feel like I've always been blessed with is great friends that have surrounded me. But I think over the last 8 years, I've come to a better understanding of what true community is. And I think what I've learned is that that is a group of people that they're friends, but they also go further. They walk through life with you, like literally alongside of you. And that kind of shows itself in a lot of different ways. One, I think that true community is a place of no judgment. I think it's also a place where you can celebrate life victories and successes and milestones together. And then in the next moment, you might be grieving the losses of things. And so I think I've just understood a deeper meaning of friendship and true community.
How has this community impacted you?
I think if I could say in one word what community and the true understanding of it has done in me is it has been a life-changing thing. I guess I can just say as a single guy, I have lived often alone in the sense that, you know, I'm in a house alone and I'm not always in the presence of others. And I believe that even over the last year and a half, our world has really understood more about being alone as we've traveled and navigated through this pandemic, which has been really hard. And I even think about people who have experienced loss during this pandemic and have been left alone and how tragic and heavy that must be. And actually, if anyone watching, if that's been you, I just want to say I'm so sorry for that, that I do know that I can't imagine how hard that's been. But I think that there's been more of an awareness come to our world of what loneliness really is. And so I think for me, you ask, how has community impacted me? I think I would just say I have seen through both words and actions, my community literally say to me, Chris, you are valued. You belong with us. You are known. We love you. And this has just been this feeling of like this community saying, we refuse to allow you to be alone. You are going to be a part of something bigger. And that's pretty impactful. That's pretty awesome.
What would you say to anyone who might be lonely or without community?
I think first I would just acknowledge that for one, loneliness is common. But even though it's common, it's also serious that loneliness is hard and it can actually be somewhat of a dangerous thing. You know, when I think of lonely and when I say that word, I don't just think about the idea of someone just being without people around them, but it's this feeling of being alone in the world. And sometimes we can be alone in the sense that nobody physically is around us. But other times we have people around us, but we still feel lonely. And I think that's the part that is scary and that can be dangerous when we just feel like we don't have anybody to turn to and we feel just alone in the world. And so, you know, I think if I could say anything, I would just remind people that we have this incredible promise from God, a God who is loving, who is kind, who is good, who is so faithful that he will always be with us at all times. And so in the moments when we are feeling alone, first of all, just that promise is incredible, straight from the Bible that he's told us. I think the other incredible thing that I would say that I have experienced and hopefully you've kind of gathered from my story is that not only does God say it in the Bible, but I believe that community is this gift that he gives us of his physical presence. He uses people to be himself in flesh and blood and offer his presence. And so I think just to lean into community, and I think sometimes for people it's hard and you have to be a little brave sometimes to be vulnerable and to step into new situations and meet new people and open yourself to community. But when you do, I truly think that God does incredible things.
Is there a specific Bible passage that's helped you remember that God's always with you when you're lonely?
Yeah, you know, one that I have always loved and that has been really meaningful to me is Psalm 23. And this is what it says. The Lord is my shepherd. He cares for me always. He provides me rest in rich green fields beside streams of refreshing water. He soothes my fears. He makes me whole again, steering me off worn hard paths to roads where truth and righteousness echo his name. Even in the unending shadows of death's darkness, I am not overcome by fear because you are with me in those dark moments. Near with your protection and your guidance, I am comforted. You spread out a table for me, provisions in the midst of attack from my enemies. You care for all my needs, anointing my head with soothing, fragrant oil, filling my cup again and again with your grace. Certainly your faithful protection and loving provision will pursue me where I go, always, everywhere. I mean, that passage for me has just been incredible. It's been an encouragement to me. I hope it can be an encouragement to anyone listening, just that God is always with us, that he's for us, that we never have to worry about being alone in the world. Even if we are physically alone in a moment, that he sees us, he values us, and he's with us. And so I've been encouraged by that, and I hope that everyone can be encouraged by that today.
Man, Chris, thank you so much for sharing. And Corbin, thanks for the great interviewing that you just did as well. I don't know about you all listening at home, but I'm so inspired by the way God revealed to Chris the different ways that he connects us to others. That as we are not always in nuclear families, as we don't always have family that are close, and even when we do have family that are close, that's not always the connection we'd want it to be, that God does not leave us alone in those moments, but that he finds a way to connect us with people that will bring us life, that will support us both practically and emotionally and spiritually, and that you and I are never alone if God is our shepherd guiding our steps. And in fact, as we reflect on that, I invite you to join me as we listen to Rachel as she sings a song of hope and reflection in this Advent season.
Underneath the starry sky, a mother holds a child tonight. All is calm and all is bright. She sings to him a lullaby. Gloria. Staring at the face of God, she looks upon the great I am, the gift of heaven in her hand, born to save the sons of earth. He was born to give them second birth.
All of the heavens ringing, Gloria. The
Savior of the world is in her arms. She's staring at the face of God. The face of God.
Thank you for that beautiful song, Rachel. And for those of you that are joining us at home, let's just pray in thanks to God. Lord God, you are so good to us. Good enough to send your own son into a manger so that he could be the savior of the world, but also good enough that you do not ever leave us alone. So Lord, help us to see your face in all of the walks of life that we're in. Help us to recognize the life-giving community that you have placed around us, if we're just have our eyes open to see it. And Lord, just guide us and bring us through this Christmas season well. Bring us through not just the stress and the uncertainty and the frustration, but Lord, help us to find our way through to the joy of knowing that you were not only with us 2,000 years ago in a stable in Bethlehem, but that you are with us here and now today, every single step of our lives. Amen. A few things before you go. We do have Christmas services coming up, and if you'd like to worship with us online, we will be dropping our big Christmas Eve service at 11 a.m. on December 24th. So you can tune in and worship God with us that way. We're also doing our weekend service on December 26th, virtual only as well. So there will be no in-person church the day after Christmas, but we do invite you to join us online just like you're doing here and now. And if anything about this service was helpful or inspirational for you, you think that it would be meaningful to someone else in your life, I encourage you to share it, get the word out there, because ultimately we just want God's good news, the hope that comes from knowing him in this Christmas season. That's the word we want to spread. And so help us out by subscribing, sharing, and bringing this message of good news to everyone in your circle. But with that, I pray God's blessings on you. May he bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May our God look upon you with his countenance and grant you his peace. Amen.